Welcome back. Well, Senator Matthew Raide joins us now from our studios in Benin. Good morning, Senator. Thank you for joining us today. Well, the list that has been making the rounds about NDDC, your name was listed as one of the beneficiaries of some contracts from the NDDC, and there's been certain tongues wagging. How come your name made the list?
Thank you very much, Chamberlain, for having me here and for this privilege. Good morning, viewers. First, let me say that whatever the intention of the Minister of Niger Delta Affairs, you know, my former colleague in the Senate, Senator Akpabio, you know, really is, you know, in positing wrong information in public domain. And of course, misinforming members of my constituency, you know, with the wrong notion that, you know, I have been a beneficiary of contract awards in the NDDC. This privilege that I have, you know, to explain some of the things, you know, with regard to this misinformation, you know, I thank channels for it. A few days ago, I had the privilege too of explaining this, you know, using another media. I'm here today, you know, to say the same thing again, you know, using this platform. First and foremost, I want to say that all the claims by
he says there were six contracts.
Yes. In fact, I want to even say that Akpabio's records are not even correct. The contracts I've attracted to my constituency are in excess of 11. So, I mean, for Akpabio to come about six, it tells you that house really, you know, is not organized.
But is there some truth in that letter? If it's 11 and not six, what does that mean?
There is no truth. Now, I'm the one telling you, you said six, I'm telling you 11. Okay? Because he doesn't know what is going on. It's unfortunate that Akpabio was with us in the Senate, who was a member of the Niger Delta Committee, just like myself. We come and say that we are beneficiaries, or me, let me talk about myself. I'm a beneficiary of the contracts in NDDC since 2015 that I got to the Senate. It's unfortunate, but let me put the record straight. The six contracts that Akpabio mentioned, four of them are streetlight projects in Oredo, Igbobaoka, Ego, and Anurium, four of them. The projects are ongoing. Those contracts were awarded through competitive bidding in 2018. Until today, those jobs have not been completed. The contractors that they chose to do those jobs to date have not been mobilized with one naira, and those jobs have not been completed. So for Akpabio to say I'll be a beneficiary is unfortunate, it's a wicked lie, and then of course, I just believe whatever mischief he wanted to perpetrate, you know, I think Nigerians, you know, through my own explanation, should be able to read between the lines. Other two road projects that were given, those road projects are Noega Access Street, and then, of course, Omoragun, one other street, you know, an adjoining street. Those road projects, they have been done. Till today, the contractor they awarded those contracts to, they have not been paid. They chose those contractors themselves. And, of course, I was not connected with it. Other projects that were given, I live on Etete Street. Etete Street was awarded in 2016. Till today, the contractor was not mobilized. The contractor did not go to the site. Idusoge Street was given, and today, till today, the contractor did not go to site. Akpabo Neka Street around the Ugbo area was given, but they were not mobilized. They did not go to site. This is the background. Now, what Akpabio has said is that those six contracts that were given, I have benefited from them, and I'm saying never. The contractors that were brought, I don't know them. Number two, those contracts have not been paid for. So why did I benefit from it? It's just a wicked lie. Maybe my other colleagues too have the same position. I have not, and for Akpabio was returning the Senate. Since this ninth assembly, nobody has gotten anything. How many did Akpabio get in 2018? Because he was a complainant like me.
Are you suggesting he equally benefited or got some as well?
Let him say so.
No, you said he was there with you. Do you think he benefited?
He too complained that jobs were not paid for in our constituencies, even though we attract this project. Of course, NDDC is a interventionist agency. I am from the Niger Delta State, Edo State.
Senator, just one moment. Can you clear something? These projects that you mentioned, are they supposed to be constituency projects or NDDC projects in your constituency?
They are NDDC projects in my constituency. Okay, the way it works is this. All of us who are from the nine states, of course, I'm from the senatorial district that bears oil and gas in Edo State. I've been a member of that committee since 2015. When they come to our state, naturally, they have what they call their regional projects. Those regional projects come, from them, across the nine states. But we that are from the states, having our own commissioners who are NDDC commissioners or nominees or whatever they call members from our states, when they come with their project, with their budget, they want input from us. Oh, I will say where I live. In fact, on this street, where you are now, they call it Lucky Way. It's about 1 kilometer. I put all the lights on this street, NDDC. Their job that is doing is still ongoing, but they have finished this street. It's about 1 kilometer. I was the one that put it there because this local government area where you are situated is a Kobaka local government area. So I have three areas where I put these lights, okay, because of the yearning of the people. That is part of the representation we'll talk about.
When you say Senator, was it your company that put it there?
No, that is the mischief. How did they choose the company? They are awarded those things. If you go back and find out that I chose these companies, then of course you know the complicity is talking about. How did you choose the companies?
You used the article I. You said I put these lights there on the street. So that assumption,
I put it in the budget. I suggested the projects.
Okay. Another thing that a number of people may say is regarding that one is, you don't have to. No one expects that your name is going to be in any of those companies or any senator's name is going to be on any of those companies. Some would assume that you could easily use proxies.
Look, with that assumption, it now becomes a legal issue. If I am telling you I did not use proxies, these contracts were bidded for, they were advertised, and people bidded for them. If NDDC that gave out these contracts, Akpabio wasn't even there, can they put their hand on paper to say I lobbied, I brought proxies to do these jobs? It's not the first time. And that is the crux of the matter. Or that the money that was spent, I brought companies or proxies that did not do the job and I stole the money. That is one of the implications.
Just give us a minute, Senator. Could you go ahead and tell us, when you say all of these are not true, does that then mean that if they check the records, they will not find your name or any company associated with you executing any of these contracts?
Now, thank you, Chamberlain. Let me quickly just tell you. The contract that was awarded to ETT3 was given to Dijanti Nigeria Limited. The one for Neka Akpabio was given to Simaco Construction Company. The Dusoge Eweka was given to AC Egbe Construction Company. All these companies, before they predate the time I entered the Senate in 2015, working with NDDC.
Able to put it there.
Raytan Limited has been working with NDDC before I became a senator.
So how then did you say that you put the contracts there?
I put the project. When you put the project in their budget, they usually come and ask what in your state, Edo State.
So Senator, if that were the case, if no such benefits that you like everyone to believe, why then do members lobby to be in those committees and call them juicy committees?
Listen, Chamberlain, the reason why I came to the Senate to be able to elicit development in my constituency in Edo South Central District. There is nothing to date to show that NDDC has done anything in my constituency. I don't want to talk about my predecessors in the office, but since I came, I've been trying frantically to elicit development in my constituency. Now, the reason why I'm there is certainly not for pecuniary reasons, what comes to my pocket as money, but the projects I bring. And of course, this one is verifiable. Okay, why I'm angry is that judging from even 9 billion that was allocated to my state NDDC budget in 2018, how many contracts came? How many projects came to Edo South? They have budget performance of 2017 of 5.3%. I did not get anything. Is it this miserable street light that is supposed to be the share of my constituency? So if I struggle to make sure that they are project,
you call them miserable. Did you put miserable street lights in your in those areas then?
No, what I'm saying in terms of the amount of money spent. Oh. We have a claim to our common patrimony in this country.
And said, so cannot be spent. Are you going to sue to clear your name?
And it's only 100 million.
Just one more thing, Senator. Are you going to sue to clear your name?
I Akpabio is a man of contradiction. I expect the next few days he's going to retract this. One, like I said, the reason
written
why
him to have you written him for that?
I have not. Because will you? This news broke about 2 days ago.
Will you write
does not retract it? Legal option will be contemplated by me. If he does not in the next few days retract it, I contemplate legal action. It's my
all
friend.
Right, Senator.
It's been my friend. And he knows that he needs to clear this.
All right. And clear thank you very much indeed, Senator.
Who are terrible people in the Senate.
All right. Thank you, Senator Matthew Irede, for speaking to us this moment.